Hello, everyone. I am getting so many messages from people overseas and from locals that I don't know who is genuine and who's an imposter. People have been messing with my brain for a long time in America. They've been hacking my brain. I don't know how I've put up with this for over 15 years. They've been stalking me and studying me and just whittling away at my being year after year, removing parts of me. It feels like they're breaking me down, like they want to possess me, but I feel like I'm being deluded. And the whole time they're doing this, they're telling me that they're making me better, when actually they're doing the opposite. This is not making me better. They're slowly killing me. My health went from absolutely perfect to everything is messing up now. My blood work, it's horrible. I remember the first year I published a story called A Farmer's Daughter, and they sent me to the emergency room attacking my heart. I went to Audubon, and lo and behold, on the way home, I had to take a taxi cab, and I met a girl who happened to be delivered by the nun that my book was about. How incredible is that? That's God's power. I mean, her mother had had the baby, but she was having difficulties. So my best friend, the little nun, Sister Alwenia, she went in and said a prayer, and the woman got relief, and her baby came smooth after that. And she did this all the time. There have been mothers that the doctor didn't think would make it, and then later when she visited them, they came through with flying colors. That's not unusual. But I remember dedicating a book to her and giving her one I had a copy of with me at the hospital. And this group just went gung-ho attacking me. And one of the people that is a actor, director for the film group that I've been using my work, he used a part of my book cover I personally designed on a movie poster. And in the story, people said that he based the character on me, and it was a woman who was eventually possessed by the devil. And this group had been following her like people follow me. You can see them following me everywhere, and sometimes people say they're called the Watchers. And they're very dark, and they try to be mysterious. And I try to overlook them. But then people try to play games with me online, and I overlook them. Only they're in my computer every day. So sometimes I talk to them with no awareness that they're a part of this group, because this group consists of so many people. So things were going terrible, but I was alive. And now that I've reached a point where I have enough strength and confidence to push these enemies out of my mind, and I'm close to God, and I'm just totally overlooking anything negative. I'm not getting excited about their dark threats or their images or their gore. Anything evil, deceptive, negative they send me now, I'm not letting it affect me. So now they're saying they want to kill me. They really do want to kill me. So now they're saying I'm supposed to pick between a few men who I want to be the executioner. Can you believe this? This group is twisted. But what I found in America, it's making people so crazy, is the deception. Is everything is done in darkness. These people rely on secrecy, and that is totally evil, like devil codes and stuff. And I grew up with people around me being very professional and very honest, and they had integrity, and what you see is what you get. And I always thought that people that behave like this were weak, and that they weren't very, very strong, or they weren't very intelligent to behave this way. I always wanted to deal in fact and honesty, and I'm married to a man who's very professional, and his professional depends on honesty. You know, you can't be in his job and be dishonest. You know, so I'm the kind of person that people said always took life too seriously, and I was very serious. So I see things as life and death. And I see life as very important, and the human spirit is sacred, and powerful through God. And so I value people sometimes a lot more than they value themselves. And I don't play around with the dark side. And when I see these people playing around with spirits, I get very depressed. But it really broke me down and destroyed my heart when I saw them start putting me in their film projects and putting me in drawings, like sometimes cartoons through Disney. But their drawings, they always try to make me sad if I sit enslaved. And they'll put like butterflies around me, or they'll put tears in my eyes. And one time they drew a picture of me in a room, because they had kept me enslaved in my home with these weapons, enslaved through torturing me through these unseen weapons. Some people say they're space weapons, some people say they're satellites, some people say they're locals with handheld devices. But anyhow, they knew they had enslaved me for years. And there was just this person, young person, wasting away, and she was looking at a brick wall. And a brick wall over her window that was covering the scenery. And in other pictures of me they drew, they had me sitting in a chair in a room with holes in the walls and cobwebs, because she had sat there so long enslaved by this cult, and her window was boarded up. And I can see them putting woods and forests and stuff in their art in all the different museums. And woods that have tunnels, like trees, and you see this greenery, but there's no outlet. And it's like they're trying, I think they're trying to take people's soul. And so now they're trying to tell me that I'm supposed to pick an executioner, which is totally bizarre. But when you don't let them get through to you, and you're positive, and you think that faith through God is more powerful, and you cut them off, they act as if you're in hell and they're Satan. And they think that you're pushing the demons out. You won't let the demons in. And they want the demons to get in and talk to you. So if you don't let the demons talk to you, then they threaten to kill you. And that's what they're doing now. They have made my life a total nightmare. They have not let me live for 15 years. And all this time, they thought they were extracting my soul and destroying my heart. And they have been destroying my mind. And they said that they won't stop until I'm totally demonic and controlled, or else I'm in hell with them.